The promise object is used for deferred and asynchronous computations. Okay, great. This statement is less than helpful if your understanding of the word asynchronous is less than certain. So the question is, what is asynchronous work? Asynchronous work happens at an unknown or unpredictable time. Normally, code is synchronous. One statement executes, like this one, and there's a guarantee that the next statement executes immediately afterwards. Threading on processors doesn't necessarily guarantee that. However, the JavaScript threading model ensures that for all intents and purposes, JavaScript runs in a single timeline. Unlike synchronous code, asynchronous code is not guaranteed to execute in a single unbroken timeline. In fact, you should assume that you have no idea when asynchronous operations will complete. In a situation like this, for example, you can't even assume that just because you send out the first request first and the second request second, that the first request will return sooner than the second. Assume that either order is equally likely as the fact that one or both requests just might fail altogether. Network requests aren't the only examples of asynchronous code. Any code that relies on processes like these, like events, like threads, or just some kind of unknowable finishing time are asynchronous. So the big question is, what is the best way to handle asynchronous code? Okay, the answer is obviously promises. Duh, that's why you're here.